Okay, I'm JD McGuire, owner of AIP Tactical. The reason I'm doing this video is some of my clients want the OEM tube extension on their AIP Tactical shotguns. And it's very important with the Remington extension that it's installed correctly. If it's not installed correctly, you get a gap between the mag tube coupling and the tube where your spring can hang up. So if I have this video out there, my clients should be able to come to it, see how to install it correctly. First thing we're going to do is we're going to make sure our safety's on. We're going to clear our weapon, make sure it's empty. We're going to remove the extension. As with any screw, always start with the right side screwdriver. If it's too small, you're going to strip the screw out. If it's too big in this case, you're going to gouge the sides of the bracket. So get the right size flathead. Only takes a few turns, it'll roll out in your hand. Now when you do this, check the bracket to make sure it's loose. This is a new 870, you can see the bracket's pretty loose, so slide it off carefully. If the bracket's tight and you just grab it and rip it off, you're going to get scratches down both sides of the barrel and both sides of the tube. Look at any Remington with a tube extension on the range, you're probably going to see those scratches. But this one's loose, we're going to pull it straight off. Okay? Then we're going to take our tube off as a one-piece unit. We just start screwing it off. Now, if this thing will not turn, it's very simple. Jason, can you hand me that strip of rubber there? Yep, and the channel locks. Thank you. That's Jason, AIP's professional cameraman. Just simply take, I use a little piece of neoprene, you can use webbing, put your channel locks on it, break it. And once you get it broke, it's going to screw right off. Okay? So be ready to capture the spring as it comes out. Okay? And then you continue with, you know, breaking it down. Follower comes out. Okay. Now, to reinstall it, simply always put your fore in about in the middle if you want to get this barrel on correctly. Slide your barrel back on. Take your mag tube coupling, screw it off the tube, and screw it on first. Hear that ratcheting sound? Okay, this keeps the barrel in place, plus by putting it on first, we're going to get a correct coupling. We'll put our follower in. And Jason, let me know if I'm getting my old clumsy hands in the way here, okay? We're going to feed our spring down and capture it. We'll slide our tube over. Get your tube started. Now, when you have a few threads left, I take the heel of my hand, I bang it. I want to make sure that the spring does not wedge in between this and this. Because if it wedges there, my tube's going to feel tight. I'm going to put my bracket back on. I'm going to think everything's a go. I might only be able to get 5 rounds in there. Or if I get 6, sometime during my course of fire, probably when my butt's on the line, that spring's going to slip back into that groove and hang up and will not feed a shell onto my carrier. So I screw it down, I pop it, I know my spring's not in the gap. I slide my bracket back on. Now if you look at this rim cutout here, the purpose of that is for the screw. So when you put your bracket on, you have to line it up with that cutout, drop your screw through, a couple turns, do not over tighten it. Now we know this is installed correctly, we have no gap here for the spring to catch, this weapon's gonna operate when we need it to.